saying to you about their experiences.
Sponsored by Pfizer.
Hello, everyone. I'm Tanya Rivero. Thank you for joining us tonight for our CBSN Originals, North Korea, The Art of Surviving Sanctions. The first year of the Trump presidency was marked by an escalating feud between the United States and North Korea, but a tit-for-tat war of words and promises of fire and fury were surprisingly extinguished. President Trump declared success in June 2018 after a historic summit in Singapore with North Korean leader Kim Jong-un. The commander-in-chief touted that through apt negotiations and newfound friendship, the regime was no longer a nuclear threat.
But we signed a very, very comprehensive document, and I believe he's going to live up to that document. In fact, when he lands, which is going to be shortly, I think that he will start that process right away.
And now we're well on our way to get denuclearization. And the agreement says there will be total denuclearization. Nobody wants to report that. So the only thing I did was I met. I got along with him great. He is great. We have a great chemistry together. That's a good thing.
But a recent report suggests that may not be the case. According to the New York Times, North Korea is actually moving forward with its ballistic missile program and provides satellite imagery of over a dozen hidden North Korean bases known to American intelligence agencies. This all comes despite a maximum economic pressure campaign on North Korea from the United States. U.S.-imposed sanctions have been restrictive. The goal is to ultimately hinder Pyongyang's development of nuclear technology and trade. Meanwhile, denuclearization of the Korean Peninsula does not seem to be tangible anytime soon. We're getting a closer look at one way the isolated country has been able to evade U.S. sanctions. And as CBSN Originals learned, it is literally an art form for the regime.
The North Korean missile was fired from the capital, Pyongyang, and flew over U.S. ally Japan.